AI agents can reason and act autonomously to achieve goals. And unlike a chatbot that only responds one prompt at a time, AI agents maintain state and can break down complex tasks into subtasks, execute them in a sequence or all at once in parallel, and then adjust their plan based on intermediate results to ultimately execute actions towards a defined goal. But what goal? Well, let's take a look at some specific use cases where AI agents are being put to work today and see how all of this planning and executing and feedback looping can provide some practical real-world benefit. And we're going to focus on three use cases in particular. And yeah, I know this video promises 10 use cases, and we'll do 10, but the three I want to focus on first, well, they relate to Internet of Things, or IoT. That's the first one. The second one we'll look at relates to retrieval augmented generation. That's RAG. And then the third one we're going to take a look at are multi-agent workflows, which is just, well, multi-agent. So let's take a look. So let's start with agriculture. And AI agents, they can help farmers increase yield and reduce waste by autonomously monitoring conditions and then optimizing farming decisions. And let's use a common framework to show how AI agents can enable these use cases. And the first part of that framework is to start with a goal. This is a goal for the agent to achieve, and perhaps that's to maximize crop yield. Once we have a goal, we can start planning as to how we're actually going to achieve that by using a planner. Now, in this case, this uses an LLM with access to external tools to plan a workflow to achieve the goal. And in this instance, the agent's tools use APIs to fetch the latest available data sources like the current weather conditions and current soil readings. Now, that information is then combined with whatever is stored in the memory. That stores past actions, history, and other contextually relevant information like the date of the last irrigation. And that all feeds into the executor, which is the next stage. And that's where an agent uses all of this information to generate an action plan. So perhaps the agent derives the appropriate action in this particular case is to turn on irrigation for the next 2 hours. Now, that execution plan, that's passed to the final stage, which is the action component, which in this case might integrate with Internet of Things controllers to perform the irrigation process. And this process is both iterative, it's continually updating, planning, execution, and action based upon changing sensor data. And it's also self-improving, where the agent learns from results, such as crop growth outcomes, and adjusts its decisions as it becomes better at resource-efficient farming. So agricultural AI agents interfacing with IoT controllers. So let's move on from the essential world of agriculture to grow food to the equally essential world of content creation to write blog posts. And as any middle school teacher tasked with grading homework can tell you, generative AI can produce reams of somewhat human-like text, but agentic AI takes things a step further. It can plan the content, gather relevant information, and then iteratively refine the output. So for this use case, let's set a goal to write a blog post on the benefits of solar energy, and the audience for this are going to be for students. Now, here the planner might use tool access to search for current solar energy statistics, recent case studies, relevant research papers, and stuff like that. So the agent here is performing document loading. It uses a search tool to find the most relevant articles. And this is where retrieval augmented generation, or RAG, comes in. The agent splits these documents into chunks, and those chunks get embedded into a vector database, which becomes the agent's memory for this specific task. Now, when the executor starts writing using a large language model, it doesn't just rely on the large language model's training data, which is probably from years ago. Instead, it retrieves the most relevant information from that fresh vector store based on the section it's currently writing. So if it's drafting the economic benefits section, it pulls up the latest cost per kilowatt statistics. Now, the agent action is to populate the blog post outline, incorporating those recalled facts and adjust the tone for the target audience. And again, the agent can work in an iterative way to refine its work. So it might generate a first draft and then critique its own writing by asking questions like, is this section well supported by the data? Or does the tone match the brief, which is for students? If it finds gaps, it goes back to search for more specific information or it adjusts the writing style. So that's agentic content creation incorporating RAG. Next up, disaster response. So when a major earthquake hits or wildfires are spreading, every second counts. And frankly, no single human can monitor satellite feeds and social media posts and 911 transcripts and sensor data all at the same time. Nobody could do that, but AI agents can. And this is where the multiple agent or the multi-agent workflow comes in. So for this use case, let's set a goal to coordinate emergency response after a major earthquake. Now here, the planner is actually a coordinator agent working with specialist agents. So we might have one specialist agent analyzing satellite imagery for collapsed buildings. We might have another that's scanning social media for distress posts. And maybe we've got a third agent, which is a simulation model that forecasts expected damage. Each specialist agent feeds intelligence back to the main planner. Now, the memory component is a shared situational map that all agents can read from and write to. So when the social media agent detects help requests from a specific neighborhood, that gets flagged into memory. Now, the executor that recommends actions and the action component coordinates the actual response, dispatching fire trucks, routing ambulances, sending evacuation alerts, and so forth. So this multi-agent approach means that agents work in parallel across different areas simultaneously. That's multi-agent disaster response coordination. Now, I promise you 10 use cases, but I don't want to keep you here all day. So let's rapid fire through the remaining 7. Ready? Right, so in banking and finance, agents demonstrate real-time stream processing, continuously ingesting transaction data and using anomaly detection models to flag fraud. For customer experience, agents use sentiment analysis. They analyze customer tone to adjust their responses. In healthcare, we see multi-agent coordination again. This time, specialized sub-agents handle different tasks like analyzing lab results and managing prescriptions. Human resources agents highlight workflow automation. They execute multi-step processes like onboarding new employees, automatically integrating with enterprise systems like Workday or SAP. For IT operations, agents use automated remediation, parsing thousands of system alerts to identify root causes, then executing scripts to fix issues. Supply chain agents use predictive analytics, forecasting demand based on market conditions. And transportation agents are good examples of dynamic replanning, continuously recalculating optimal routes as conditions change. And each of these use cases follows the same fundamental pattern of goal, planner, memory, executor, and action, all working together to help AI agents meet user goals.